In this video, the teacher uses explicit systematic instruction. During the first step of explicit systematic instruction, the teacher readies the students for the lesson.
All right, boys and girls, today during math class, we are going to be adding one-digit numbers by drawing pictures. Now, in the past, we've used 10 frames to help us add. Show me a thumbs up if you remember using 10 frames to help you add. I see lots of thumbs up out there. Lots of you remember. We've also used counters before to help us add. Show me a thumbs up if you remember using counters. See lots more thumbs up too. Lots of you remember. Well, today we're going to be adding by drawing pictures. And we're going to do this because you aren't always going to have counters in your pockets or 10 frames in your backpacks to help you. So today I'm going to teach you how you can draw a picture that's going to help you add two numbers together.
During the next step, the teacher leads the students through several problems, modeling the procedures.
We're going to start with this problem here, 2 plus 4. To start, I'm going to draw dots to show my first number 2. 1, 2. Dominique, how many dots did I draw?
2.
That's right, I drew 2 dots. Next, I need to draw 4 dots. Mateo, how many dots do I need to draw next?
4.
That's right, I need to draw 4 dots. I'm going to come over here and draw 4 dots. Now I want to make sure that my picture matches the problem. So I'm going to count and make sure I have 1, 2, and then here I have 1, 2. You know, those dots are kind of messy. If I'm going to be drawing a picture, I need my dots to be nice and neat. So I'm going to draw my dots down below. 2, 3, 4. Now I've drawn 4 dots. My last step is to count all the dots to see how many dots I have altogether. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 dots. Carlos, how many dots do I have?
6.
That's right, I have 6 dots. So I know that 2 plus 4 equals 6. Now something I want you to remember. When you're adding, sometimes you may know the answer right away, and that's awesome. Other times you may not know the answer right away. And that is one example of a time when you may want to draw a picture to help you add.
After the teacher leads students through several problems, she then implements teacher-guided practice.
Now, I'm going to have you do the next 3 problems with a partner. I'm going to walk around the class, and I'm going to answer any questions or help you as needed.
After the teacher has monitored the students during teacher-guided practice and provided corrective feedback, she asks students to complete problems independently. To ensure maintenance, the teacher plans for opportunities for ongoing practice and provides instruction for students who have not mastered the concept or procedure.